Will this new spy plane take America's air game to new heights? In December 2013, Aviation Week revealed that the U.S. was quietly working on a big, stealthy spy plane designed to take over the job of the retired SR-71 aircraft. However, the real question still hangs in the air, whether it can surpass its SR-71 predecessor. The RQ-180 is not much talked about yet, for a good reason. There isn't much reliable information available about this highly secretive system. But this spy plane is applauded by many for its brand new and game-changing features. The U.S. currently has several advanced aircraft being developed that are publicly known, but still highly secret, like the stealth B-21 Raider bomber and two new stealth fighters in the Air Force and Navy programs. Despite being the focus of public attention, these projects remain largely secret. However, not all of the country's most advanced military programs are as well known. Some remain hidden for years, only briefly becoming public before disappearing into covert operations. For example, the stealth Blackhawks used in the 2011 mission to kill Osama bin Laden still haven't been officially acknowledged, even though a part of one crashed and was left behind. These classified projects involve some of the most advanced military technology in the world, and part of maintaining their strategic advantage is keeping their capabilities secret. The stealth Blackhawks are just one example, and there's a good chance that even more advanced aircraft, possibly the flying wing referred to as the RQ-180, though that might not even be its real name, are in operation today. This platform developed by Northrop Grumman is probably the most advanced intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance asset ever created. According to media reports, it has likely been in operation for several years. Many believe this aircraft is more than just a top-secret spy plane. It might be the key element in America's new strategy for aerial combat. Operating at an altitude of 70,000 feet, it oversees a range of advanced stealth fighters, bombers, drones, and even weapon systems, directing their operations and receiving data from them. In other words, while the RQ-10 could potentially replace the SR-71 Blackbird in some ways, evidence suggests it has a much broader role. To grasp the significance of the RQ-10, we need to understand its origins. After the September 11, 2001 terrorist attacks, the U.S. rapidly shifted back to a wartime posture, preparing for a long-term military response. However, as military forces mobilized, Pentagon officials faced a major challenge similar to the SR-71s. Despite America's extensive satellite network, there weren't enough satellites with the necessary capabilities to provide the intelligence required for effective military planning. The United States urgently needed a major boost in intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance capabilities to cover the vast areas of two Middle Eastern conflict zones. At that time, no aircraft could match the capabilities of the Blackbird. Just 2 days after the September 11th attacks, the Pentagon had already developed a $45 million plan to reactivate the Blackbird for the second time. The goal was to use the aircraft to gather crucial intelligence on terrorist targets in the and to utilize its ability to create sonic booms as a form of psychological warfare, demonstrating America's powerful air capability. However, this plan did not receive the necessary political backing. Instead, the defense sector shifted its focus to investing billions of dollars into improving existing ISR platforms and technologies and developing new ones. 2 months after the attacks, Northrop Grumman's high-altitude RQ-4 Global Hawk was put into service. Existing platforms like the MQ-1 Predator quickly gained attention, leading to increased investment in its successor, the MQ-9 Reaper. Additionally, a number of smaller unmanned aerial vehicles were introduced, such as the RQ-11 Raven in 2003 and the RQ-2 Puma in 2007. These platforms laid the groundwork for the ISR capabilities that shaped the global war on terror, gradually changing how American forces used timely intelligence in combat. The days of U-2s and SR-71s taking photographs on long rolls of film, which took days to develop, were over. Instead, these unmanned aircraft could stream live video directly to commanders and decision-makers in Washington in real time. This shift in intelligence and target acquisition quickly gained momentum as more commanders recognized the value of these ISR platforms. However, the U.S. soon found itself struggling to deploy enough modern ISR aircraft to meet the growing demand, a challenge that continues today. Lieutenant Colonel Andrew Evans from the Army's ISR Task Force. notes there is an unquenchable need for airborne ISR capabilities across all combat commands. We receive weekly requests for more, but the joint staff can't meet this demand due to capacity limitations. Despite significant investments in new ISR aircraft, these solutions had a major drawback. Designed to be cost-effective for the relatively safe airspace of the global war on terror, many lacked the stealth and performance needed for more contested environments. For instance, the MQ-1's maximum altitude of 25,000 feet meant it might occasionally face threats like shoulder-fired missiles, though the biggest issue it faced was often adverse weather. Not all new ISR platforms were so limited. In the early 2000s, Lockheed Martin began developing a stealthy flying wing drone designed to operate in contested airspace, such as over Iran. Building on earlier projects like the RQ-3 Darkstar, this secretive drone had a wingspan of around 65 feet, making it significantly wider than an A-10 Warthog. Publicly, it was first seen operating from Kar in Afghanistan and earned the nickname Beast of Kar. The Air Force later revealed that its official designation was RQ-170. This aircraft was managed by the 432nd Wing at Creech Air Force Base in Nevada and the 30th Reconnaissance Squadron at the Tonopah Test Range in Nevada. Before the RQ-170, there were many other secrets hidden in U.S. hangars. It's not completely clear, but it seems likely that the RQ-180, now known, developed from the Joint Unmanned Combat Air Systems Program, which also produced the Boeing X-45 and the Northrop Grumman X-47, including the X-47B, which still appears in conspiracy posts online due to its futuristic design and striking carrier-based photos. Reports indicate that Northrop Grumman received a contract for the RQ-180's development around 2008, the same period Lockheed Martin started work on their own ISR solution with the SR-72. While the SR-72 is still reportedly in the phase, the RQ-180 seems to have entered low-rate initial production as early as 2013. Unlike the ISR platforms used during the global war on terror, the RQ-180 was designed to withstand the most challenging airspace conditions, offering continuous intelligence despite advancing ground radar and airborne enemy patrols. It likely achieves this with a highly efficient aerodynamic design and all-aspect stealth, which makes it harder to detect across a broad range of radar frequencies compared to the F-22, F-35, or B-2 Spirit. Like the X-47B, the RQ-180 is thought to use a cranked-kite shape, differing from the flying wing design common in stealth bombers. There are no officially released photos of the RQ-180, but some believe to be of it showed the aircraft in flight. The RQ-180 is reportedly about twice the size of the RQ-170, potentially offering double the fuel capacity for extended missions. Its wingspan is about 130 feet, smaller than the B-2 Spirit, but similar to the B-21 Raider. It features an arcing jet inlet on top to reduce radar visibility from below and a rear edge similar to the B-21. Some believe the RQ-180 is known among operators as the Great White Bat, or Shikaka, a reference to the movie Ace Ventura 2. Reports suggest the RQ-180 was tested over Area 51 between 2000 and 2010 and 2014, with at least 7 in service by 2015. By 2017, these aircraft were reportedly operational, joining the fleets of RQ-4 Global Hawks and U-2s at Beale Air Force Base in California and another unit in Guam, providing crucial capabilities for long-duration ISR missions. The first potential sighting of the RQ-180 occurred in November 2020 over the Mojave Desert in California, though some believe it might have been Lockheed Martin's Polecat, a similar-shaped aircraft that ended its program in 2006. On September 2, 2021, landscape photographer Michael Fugate captured an unusual aircraft over Santa Magdalena, Philippines. This image, published by the War Zone, showed a cranked, kite-shaped aircraft high above the Pacific. While this might have been a rare view of the RQ-180, its exact appearance remains uncertain. A month later, the same aircraft was seen over Area 51 with an image shared by Dreamland Resort, a site dedicated to monitoring the classified base. The caption noted an aircraft with a pointed tail, unlike the B-2's serrated tail. In all instances, the aircraft was photographed in daylight, suggesting it is designed to operate around the clock rather than only at night. The most detailed look at the RQ-180 may have come on November 8, 2021. Amidst its popularity among conspiracy theorists and aviation fans alike, there is no denying that the RQ-180 still holds an air of mystery around its real capabilities. One thing that only time can tell. That wraps up today's video. What are your thoughts on this super secretive flyer? Let us know in the comments. Don't forget, leave a like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell to keep tabs on precise aviation videos.